Welcome to OWAD today. I'm Sophie, your pilot into the universe of Chinese. Today's animal character is chong. And I couldn't decide, should I translate it into worm or bug? Because for Chinese, when we see this character, it could be either the soft body one, or the hard-shelled one. I don't know the exact term for that, but they're totally two different categories of animals. And chong in its ancient form. So here in simplified Chinese, it's manageable, right? Basically, it's a box, it's vertical line, and two more strokes. That's it. But in ancient times, it's really squiggly. I don't know how we can accurately copy that because the ancient times before the press, right, is a human copy things. Mostly the monks do that, who are the, I guess, the knowledge transmitters back then. How can you re-render that without quite a trouble of getting all the curves right? But this is the ancient form of worm. You can see it's a soft body. I'm not sure about what that thing is, but the whole curvature looks like soft body thing, right? But in contemporary language use, when we say chong, a lot of times it's bugs. It's insects. So it's not exactly the ancient form would revoke us for. And actually, this chong worm, soft body, spineless animal, could be different sizes. Small worm, like earthworm, is one. The other extreme would be snakes. Ooh, wait, snakes got spines actually, right? It's not soft body, it's just no legs. Okay, anyways, this squiggly shape can also apply to ancient worms. And at different points of history and time, people use this term like interchangeably with other stuff. Sometimes like a da chong, big worm, actually means tiger. So I have to say, Chinese as a general language have this habit of grabbing a term, apply it pretty freely. As long as there are some commonalities between things, it can be applied because the way we interpret things is through context. We don't rely on just one single, like right now here, the whole slide, just chong. We cannot even determine if it is a earthworm or an insect. What would be? Okay, so we have all kinds of chong bugs or worms. It could be just by this one single character. So we have to decide by the context. And I guess that's why, because Chinese is a kind of contextual language, this transfer meaning across different categories can happen just more easily. English have that blending, blend over, a bleed over of meaning with one word transfer to other space. Possible too, Chinese especially so. Okay, two expressions. 雕虫小技. This is a humility. Sayings. Okay, so in Chinese expression, at least ancient way, you're not supposed to be boastful. The appreciated character of people is be humble. Like even if you're a master of something, we wouldn't acknowledge that. And actually, we're just downplaying the capacity or magnitude of our talent. So 雕虫小技 oftentimes could be used by top-notch craftsmen come up with some really impressive mechanism, artworks, little things. They will downplay the whole thing, will say, you know, this is just 雕虫小技. Okay, just a few days ago, we came across this and we differentiate as eagle or vulture. So it's a big white wingspan bird. And this character actually got transferred into an action word, meaning sculpture. And I what do you imagine? Because this character Vulture have this peripheral or wholesomeness that's going through all angles. It's kind of like a sculpture. What sculpturing is doing, it's not a flat 2D art form. It's you have to look at from the art piece from all different angles, 360 degrees. I mean, in contemporary mathematical terms, but in ancient times, we're comparing that with a wooden bucket forming. So I don't know exactly ancient times a bucket. I guess it depends on how many, what's the perimeter of the bucket, how many panels you should use, right? To make it still circular and without leaking. So that character was the left side of that to represent the old angle. So that's transferred into sculpture. And here it says, I'm just sculpturing a little bug or worm. It's really small scale, like small scale sign, nothing to mention. So that's the Chinese self-deprecating habit. This is one example. The next one, hua chong, hua niao, yu chong. We have the type of, okay, in America, we have farmer's market, right? This is kind of a equivalent of that, except that it's kind of a China's PetSmart equivalent back then, before we, you know, go into a big, big box chain stores under one brand name. It's like a localized, people exchange, do a local market, kind of like a farmer's market. But over there, it's focusing on the hobby. So if you like potted flower, it's there, flower. You know, birds, right? Birds as pet birds, also one favorite category. Fish, naturally. But, okay, so crickets back then was a hobby among some men because they don't want to fight against each other. They have their agents, the crickets, to fight against each other. So that's MF of A, the simple animal bug form of a spectator man sport kind of thing. So hua niao yu chong was, this chong was made into this expression as one of the favorite pastimes and such hobbies of Chinese people. So there you go. And I'm kind of bug phobia. So this is the acceptable for me. I can show this to you. And it means like, we totally can say this is a chong, xiao chongzi, little bug. And this is not a worm form. So I mean, I cannot show worm. So bug is what I can do here. But in Chinese, we all know that it can mean either worm or bug. Chong. There you go. Thank you for watching. See you another day.